this week I stay in the studio in Residence Omayu, and this studio is the studio in which I stayed for 1 year from 1980 to 1981, and old memories return to me. Pierre Drini was here that time, and he was always very kind and always smiling. And Christophe was also very kind to me, and thank you very much. Your help was so great for me that time, yeah. And I could not speak English, I could not speak French at that time, so thank you. And then offer came from Israel. After offer came, Drini, every day Drini said, offer proved purity, offer proved that, offer proved this. And offer gave lectures in the lecture room there, and in the lecture he said for many times, I can prove that, I can prove that. And each time he says, I can prove that, Drini became like this. And one time, Drini could not stay on the chair. He was too much impressed by the result of OHA, and he dropped from the chair and started to swim or float on the floor. So I wrote a letter to Shuji Saito in Japan. He was still a student, and to explain that great young mathematician appeared, and I put in the letter that my drawing that Oba is saying, I can prove that, and Drini was swimming on the floor, smiling, and I, so some period I shared office with Oba, yeah. And I thought that it was better to talk with him. And so I explained what I was studying to him. Then next day, I heard his, I can prove that. And that was the end of my study. I could not understand his method, so my study finished, but I could not see how it was finished. then many people came to our office to ask questions to offer. Yeah, yeah. And they sometimes made a sequence. And then the first person entered and discussed with offer, and then became happy, saying, oh, I see, and then left the room office. And then the next one came and became happy. And one day I saw Barry Mazer in the sequence of people. And I think that time he was proving Iwasawa's main conjecture with Andrew Wiles. And probably he had some difficulty. And then he entered, and then, of course, he became very happy, saying that Offa gave a perfect answer before he explained his question well. So the memory of Offa that time is so strong for me, and he's getting greater and greater now, and so this is very nice. And I talk about the toroidal compactification of Drinfeld modules, and if a function field in one variable over finite field FQ, and infinity is fixed place of F, and A is elements in F which are integral outside F. infinity outside infinity. N is a element of A. N has assumed that N has at least two prime divisors. Yeah. And then let let MND be the moduli space of Drinfeld modules of rank D and with full N level structure. That is in the sense of Drinfeld, the Drinfeld N level structure. I don't explain it to you.
So this depends only on the ideal N, it doesn't have to be principal.
I know that yes, but today I assume that I just consider that the principal ideal, generated by N, And so then this has a property that it is regular and regular and that is smooth over FQ over FQ, and also the after inverting the N, then this is a smooth over this. I forgot to in the description of the big reaction of Drini. I felt that Drini was very happy to see a younger mathematician who was as excellent as him. Yeah, that was my strong impression which I had that time. enlargement of MND n sigma. This is a cone decomposition explained later. But in the theorem, I assume today that is just FQT. The general case, we believe that this is a joint work with Fukaya and Romeo Sharifi. And we believe that the case generally A can be case of general A is okay, but then the formulation of the result is a little different from the for general A, and then for F A equal FQT, then and also we already almost completed the paper for A equals FQT, but for general A, then the method is to reduce the problem to the case A equals FQT, but the manuscript is not yet written so much, and so I am afraid to say any wrong thing about the general case. So today I am almost sure that the paper is completed soon for this A equal FQT case. And the paper will, I hope to submit the paper to the archive in 1 week, 1 month, I hope. Yeah. And so
I think in around 94, there was a lecture of Pink in Austria.
Oh, yeah.
On smooth compactification.
Oh, yeah.
But I don't know exactly what he did because I was not in the lecture.
Okay, yeah.
And then he told me that there is some idea, I don't remember.
Yeah.
What is the relation?
Oh, yeah. Actually, I have not, yeah. Actually, he wrote a note, short note, and so I will soon say about it. I will soon say. Okay. I will say that the concerning this, the Satake compactification was, this is some minimal compactification of MNDs. This is written in this was by Kaplanov for A equals FQT case and Pink for A general. And for toroidal compactification about which I am talking about the Pink wrote a summary. This is you can see this this is published in some series of lecture notes in something in about DIMS Research Institute in Kyoto University and that can be read. But details were not yet published using results of Fujiwara. We believe that what he wrote in this note is correct and almost essentially sufficient to develop the details theory. And so I'm sorry, I have not yet contacted Pink, so I don't know why he did not write the details. I think his ideas are nice and great and yeah. So we add some log context, log thing, and we did some hard computations actually. Which are not written in that note. And so I'm not so sure why the details were not published. I have to contact him. So the theorem is that I state the theorem without showing the what is telling what is sigma. What is this moduli space and what is the moduli problem? I don't explain now. But this is log regular and this has log structure and log regular. So that is a natural generalization of log regular and proper of A and so that is this is open open set and then so open set and MND is outer tensor A. This then this is this is log smooth over A. Yeah, just as this, but putting log. Yeah. So and then this is and after there are some sigma prime subdivision, finite rational subdivision of this con decomposition subdivision of sigma. Such that for each given sigma, then we have such that MLD, M sigma is regular and this is smooth over smooth over. That is a resolution of singularity can be done in this yeah, smooth over here. And the boundary here is the normal crossing divisor and the thank you very much. Thank you very much. Sigma prime. Yeah, yeah. This is and the boundary is normal crossing simple normal crossing divisor here and the all irreducible components of the boundary are smooth and there are any intersections are also smooth over this. Such nice resolution of singularity exists. Yeah.
So when you say that your space, so you claim that the space is regular, it's log regular, let us say in the regular case even, so it maps to the curve, the spec A,
yeah.
And what is the local structure? Is it in some sense log regular if you put enough? Is it log smooth when you put enough
when you put cubic log structure? Or? Oh, yeah, because in the log regular case, this is just exactly the place where the log structure is trivial. So if you have a S log regular and then S U is a place where the log structure of this is log structure of S is trivial, then the log structure, this is log structure of M is equal to, if this is J, is equal to across the,
yes.
Yeah, so then that is, and in this case, this is exactly the place where the log structure is trivial. So the log structure of this is given by that, by those schemes. Yeah.
This is not my question. Was you said it's log smooth over A after inverting N. But if you don't invert N, but suppose I add the divisors of N to the log structure.
I don't put the log structure in A. Yeah, just the. I am not putting the log structure on A. Yeah. So then if I don't invert N, then we can say something that is there is some. Yeah, look. Yeah, maybe I may say about it later. If I have a time, the formal completion of this is MN formal completion. If you the some formal completion of this is regular and times toroidal some locally. La, you have a smooth map to oh yes, trick, yeah, the relative, I don't know I have not yet studied the what happens on the divisors of N, maybe I have, I can say something, but today I don't prepare anything about the fiber at N, that is my yeah. And so then this is a theorem which, but I have to say but we assume that A is FQT. Sorry. Otherwise the statement is should be the same, but the manuscript is not yet written. So I have to and. So then I hope to introduce a log Drinfeld module. So So first recall that Drinfeld module of rank D and module of rank D and generalized Drinfeld module module over S. So S is a scheme over A. is a this is resp, yeah, resp. Is a pair L theta, 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 phi, L phi, sorry. L phi are here, L is a line bundle on S and phi is the action of A on the additive group scheme of L. Satisfying one and two here resp two prime. So the one is that the action of this phi A is A, the multiplication by A. The second is that the so locally take isomorphism L with OS. Then the phi AX is written as so X is now in L but it is in OS. Then this is written by a polynomial and the first term is AX because it is by this. And then here the last term is unit times unit times X to the A to the D. Where A is this is the absolute value, standard absolute value of F infinity. And on the other hand, the two prime the for the generalized means that then we don't put such assumption. That is then this is just for any S then the fiber of this at S it is a Drinfeld module of rank R for some module of rank R for some rank R for some R R non zero. So here D should be non zero. That polynomial phi A should not be a linear function. That is the some higher degree should appear. Yeah. So then the remark is that roughly speaking the Satake compactification which pink compactification which pink constructed is the moduli space of generalized Drinfeld modules
does it follow that the scalars in A, like the base field FQ, acts in the usual way?
Oh yeah, that follows from the definition. Yeah. And so then, but to have a toroidal compactification, we should put some logarithmic thing. And so then, I will. So then, the next we talk about log Drinfeld modules. So the now for then by log scheme I here today this is so called FS log scheme log scheme what defined on the Zariski site the for simplicity the etal site is okay also but just to because I prepared we are writing the manuscript using Zariski site so but I think etal site is also okay and then now for let L be a line bundle on the log scheme S. Then we define L bar to be the union of L and MS inverse L cross. Where the L cross is a basis of L inside L. And MS is a log structure of S. And I have to make this more precise, but the feeling is that this is the enlargement of L putting poles which belong to MS. That is so MS inverse is F inverse F in MS inside the group MS group. And MS inverse L cross means this twist of MS inverse by OS cross this L cross is a torsor over OS cross and so then we have such thing. Yeah. And this union is a union in which we identify L cross here and L cross here. Yeah. And actually L tilde is not a strange thing. This is just sheaf of morphisms of the sheaf of morphisms to P of L plus O, which contains L as a dense subspace. And but this has S morphisms. S morphisms and this is a projective space associated to the vector bundle rail plus O. And we put a log structure here. This is just pullback log of log structure of S and plus the log by Cartier divisor log at infinity. You have the complement is a Cartier divisor, so you can put so you add the log structure coming from that Cartier divisor at infinity. So then this part is treating the outside this space outside there. Now this is not a strange thing. Then
and of course the P this is as a space of line. It's a classical projective. Lines or the space of hyperplanes. Maybe here it's an equivalent because rank two. So.
Vector, you can make a vector bundle version of this. And my big hope is that this notion is useful for the log Drinfeld modules. Then the vector bundle version may be useful for the log Stuka or something like that. The log Stuka, the Stuka is the vector bundle. So I hope that such thing can be also. Yeah, then if you put the vector bundle, you replace that L by V, and then you can have some vector bundle version of this. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And then I now now by log Drinfeld module Felt module of rank D with n level structure structure over S S is a log scheme over A. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Is such thing here L theta is a generalized Drinfeld module Drinfeld module module over S and iota is a homomorphism, not homomorphism, map of sheaves to L tilde, L bar, the homomorphism of sheaves, just sheaves, we that just map of sheaves. And because L bar is not a group, so we cannot say a homomorphism. L bar is, so then satisfying the following, maybe following sharp, yeah. And I write the condition, yeah. Yes, so I write the condition. So if in the case S is log regular. Then it is like the list and U is the part is trib the part open set of S on which the log structure is trivial and then you have J in S. Then maybe I don't know need this. Then the restriction of this to U is a Drinfeld module of rank D. And the restriction of this iota to U is a Drinfeld N level structure structure of L phi restricted to U. Yeah, yeah. So this is a condition. Yeah, that is. So in this case, you have this. Yeah. So and in the general case, the for general S, then the condition is that condition is the following. So for locally on S, there is some S prime and L prime, phi prime, iota prime, and F from S to S prime, such that over S A, this S prime is log regular. This is log regular and L prime phi prime iota prime is a log Drinfeld module Drinfeld, so maybe I call the log Drinfeld module of rank D and DN. This is a log Drinfeld module of rank D and the n-level structure on S prime in the sense which we have just defined and L prime L phi iota is a pullback of L prime phi prime iota prime.
So here F is just a morphism of log schemes?
Yeah, log schemes. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, log schemes. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You choose it to be straight?
No. Anything is fine. Yeah, anything.
Locally for the Zaleski topology or the Tal topology?
I am using, but sorry, both has a log structure for Zaleski topology, so locally. Anything is, Zaleski is okay and Tal is okay. Not, at the end, these are not, they don't give a difference. Or at the end, the global is okay because the modular space is log regular, so anything like this comes from the modular space. So I actually so that we don't need to be careful about this locally. But to study the locally is better, and so I take the risk locally. So then I have some remarks on this subject. I have 20 minutes left. Okay. Thank you very much. So the remarks are for in the case S log regular, then the for log Drinfeld module of rank D and level N is equivalent to the just the such that L phi iota this is a generalized Drinfeld module over S, and this is and such that L phi U is of Drinfeld of rank D, and this is but this one is now the level structure, in level structure on L phi U. Just in the result. Then this is just you get by restriction to U. But here you can the unique extension of iota. The such iota extends uniquely to the map on S from 1 over M to L tilde. So that is that is the first remark. And the second remark is that if L so that is I am not defining log Drinfeld module. I am just defining the log Drinfeld module with rank D with n level structure. Without n level structure I don't tell what is log Drinfeld module. This is log Drinfeld module of rank D and n level structure, then you have for any AB in this thing, you have locally on S, we have either pole A divides pole iota A divides pole iota. I will explain pole. Or pole iota B divides pole iota A. That is some total ordered structure appears. And what is pole? Pole is that L bar from L bar to MS over OS you have so L goes to 1. And then F inverse E, where F is in MS and E in L cross goes to F. That is how pole is big. The F module OS cross. Yeah, yeah. So that is the pole. Yeah. So the pole is always one divides this. One divides this means that for x divides y in m, it means that y over x is in s here, ms in os cross in ms os divided by group in the group. Yeah, the quotient is in the group, but the x divided by y means it is inside here. Yeah. Yeah. And then the third remark is that third remark is that now I assume that A is FQT. Then the story becomes special and simpler. Otherwise, there are some very complicated things. Yeah. So
the property of the poles that one divides the other, this follows from, one is to prove it using the...
The proof is not trivial. And so you have to use the structure of the local ring of log regular scheme. That is not so trivial. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So, and remark three is assume that now F is FQT. Then for L phi, iota log Drinfeld module of rank D and table N, then over S on A, over S, then locally on S, on S, there is a basis EI. So I like to make an index like this. A over N A basis of N over 1 A to the D, such that pole of E I for all I, pole of E I divides pole of A, iota E I. Iota E I divides pole of iota A for any A inside in this minus the first I equals 0 I minus 1, j equals 0 I minus 1 an EI.
So in your definition, L bar was the union of L and something else, and you define the pole just on the second part.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Second part, the first part goes to 1, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
The first part goes to
1.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Yeah, 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 yeah. I am just, yeah. So we are worrying about the pole, so. And then this remark is important, 3 is important, for the case A equals FQT. Then remark is that for any, for EI, as in remark 3, then the pole of EI is always equal to, is independent of the such choice of such EI. This pole is determined. And furthermore, and pole E0 is always 1. Yeah. Yeah. Such thing can be proved. And so I hope to use this such thing to formulate a moduli functor. Yeah. So now moduli functor is M, the functor MN from log scheme over A to set this is just the isomorphism L phi S go MN S goes to the log Drinfeld module of rank D and N over S with module isomorphism. MN bar D S D sigma. Now we use sigma. Sigma is let CD be the cone SI I 1 to I D minus 1 such that SI are real numbers, and then you have this, we consider this cone, yeah. And then let sigma be a finite rational cone decomposition. Position of CD. then you have MN bar sigma. So this sends S to be MN N sigma S is the elements L phi iota plus of this inside MNDN S such that locally on S there is a basis EI as in remark three there, yeah. And such that sigma in some cone in sigma, yeah. Such that the formula is I equals 1 to d minus 1 pole iota ei bi is in ms of os cross for any bi in z to z d minus I 1 such that bi si I cos 1 minus dy minus y is negative for any s in sigma. That is something like the poles of those torsion points are satisfying belong to sigma or something like that. The situations of poles are in sigma.
So you want SD minus 1, not SD?
Because I am here. Oh, sorry. This is D minus 1. So sorry. I am neglecting the first E0 because your pole E0 is always 1. So I am just neglecting. So sorry. So this is D minus 1. Yeah. So this is inside RD minus 1. And you have a positive element. So thank you very much. So the theorem is that this functor is representable and now the theorem here. The theorem is that assume F is FQT, then the functor MN T sigma is represented by a log scheme M bar D N sigma satisfying this theorem. So now I think I have the only 10 minutes, so then it is rather hard to explain the details of the key points of the proof. But shortly speaking, the case MT is, so let sigma 1 be the trivial decomposition, trivial, the proof, rough sketch of the proof, so trivial are con decomposition then of CD, that is the all face consisting of all faces of CD, then and if you take MT, T, this is just a blowing up of some blowing up of P, P, A, A, D minus 1. And some blowing up. I have no time to explain. And for any N, then. Just this is blowing up. For any sigma, this is a blowing up of this. T is just T of FQT. Sorry. So that if you have only one divisor, then if you invert that N, then you can get a moduli space. So the MN for MN or MN bar sigma exists only this one exists, and without this localization it is hard to define. To the, maybe in the world of stacks then they may exist, but in the usual sense that you have to after a n1 if n has only one prime divisor. So then this one is defined, and then if you have for general n, then the n can be written as n1 times n2, and n1 and n2 are 1, and they are not constant. Then mn nn sigma tensor, it is mn sigma is obtained as this, and this one is obtained as a blowing up of the integral closure of n1 sigma 1 tensor a n I 1 in m n m n. Yeah, D, sorry, D. And then finally, so this is the first remark. What the second remark is this, and then, but finally, this one, MN, and finally, the MN bar sigma 1, is the normalization of the closure of MN. MN after tensor, this is the closure of this in MD, MDKT, where we use the map FQT goes to FQN FQT. Sending t to n, then if you have a Drinfeld MN bar t sigma, if you have a, so that this gives a map from MN MD n to t MDKT, where K is the degree of N as a polynomial. That is the absolute value of N is Q to the K. That is, if you have a Drinfeld module with FQT coefficient, and then if you restrict the coefficient to this same thing, then the rank becomes is multiplied to by k, degree k, and you have a Drinfeld module over this former FQT with a higher rank. And then you have a embedding of this gives a embedding, and then you can have a MNDKT, but this sigma 1 is now a sigma 1 of C, CDQ, CDK, And then you can take a closure of this inside here. Then you get that one and this one. And then you again take the integral closure and then you have to take a blowing up. And I think that the process is so simple, but the most important part, difficult part, is to prove the log regularity of the such thing, and so that then for to have I have 2 minutes or something like that. To prove the log regularity of the such thing, we have to use the formal theory, formal completion, and then I have just one remark. I can give only one remark that we have to study something like Tate uniformization in the formal completion, just like theory of Faltings Chai in the moduli of abelian varieties. So for example, if an elliptic curve degenerates, then it is a Tate curve is like this. And then if the local moduli space is this spec of this or SPF of this the formal moduli space. That is the Q is the this Q, and then if you by this local theory you can see that the space is log regular. In this case it is regular, and in general log regular, and after inverting n it is smooth over z. So the such thing can be proved by using such formal local study by completing the story, and then just as this then. The Drinfeld module has something like Tate uniformization, but it is we need a iterated Tate uniformization that is different from the usual Tate uniformization. You have to divide something like GM, a good reduction, and then you have to divide x0 by gamma I, and then you get xi plus 1, and then the xm is the so from to get to L phi or to get E, then you can here you have only once you can get E, the elliptic curve E, just dividing GM which has good reduction dividing by some lattice. But here you have to you cannot get the Drinfeld module formally this is log Drinfeld module formally by one rank dividing by once by rank by lattice you have to divide the lattice for several you divide it for several times from starting from object of good Drinfeld module of good reduction of lower rank Yeah, so the iterated Tate uniformization, sorry, iterated Tate uniformization is necessary. But once you do this, then the local coordinate, you can find the local coordinate using the generator of such lattice. So then you can see that the space has nice coordinate functions, and space is regular, or space is smooth, log smooth. This is the main part of the story. But already in Pink's note, then such thing is illustrated using the result of Fujiwara, and so I have to contact Pink why he has not published this is the end of the story.
Well, I think you mentioned a couple of years ago you had some applications in mind for this theory.
So my I was so much in the here in the collaborator. Sharifi is in the collaborator. Why we are studying this is we are interested in Sharifi conjecture, and it is the modular symbol of GLN is related to Iwasawa theory of the modular forms of GLN minus one is our project. The case n equals two was stated in Sharifi's paper in Annals of Mathematics. We wanted to consider the n equals so f equals q, n equals two, f equals q, this is the Sharifi conjecture, original Sharifi conjecture. We are interested in the case f is a function field case. And then the theory of modular symbols and Iwasawa theory means the Iwasawa theory of modular forms of GLN minus one. Our plan is to this is comes to so called Kondo-Yasuda element element of in the K group of the modular in KN of the modular variety, Drinfeld modular variety, and MDN, and MDN. But if we compactify that, then we can consider this at boundary. The boundary is the world of GLN minus one, so this is related to this is our plan, so we started to this thing is to study. We wanted to get the boundary, we spent I think you heard my talk 3 years ago or something like that. We needed 3 years to complete the paper, and I think the paper is soon completed, at least for A equals FQT.
One more question.